Hello everyone, and let's check out another beautiful chess game by Garry Kasparov. And in this chess game, Kasparov has the white pieces, and his opponent is Jérôme Piquet. And this game was played in Netherlands in 1997, and Piquet was a grandmaster and a top-level tournament player. So Garry Kasparov, who is playing with the white pieces, starts the game with playing d4, d5. c4. The queen's gambit accepted. D takes on c4. e3. Knight to f6. And bishop takes on c4. e6. Knight to f3. c5. Kasparov castled. a6. Bishop to b3. b5. Preparing to play c4. a4 by Kasparov. b4. Knight from b to d2. Bishop to b7. e4. c takes on d4 and e5 by Kasparov, attacking the knight. Knight to d5 by Piquet, knight to c4, knight to c6, and bishop to g5. Defending the queen, rook to c1. Placing the rook in the open file, h6, bishop to h4, bishop to c5. Developing the bishop and holding on d4. Defending the pawn for two times. Black is a pawn up. Knight from f to d2. And also Piquet castled. Knight to e4. Attacking the bishop on c5. Bishop to e7. And Kasparov doesn't want to exchange his dark square bishop. So he played bishop to g3. Queen to d8. And after this move, Kasparov played knight from c to d6, and he has a perfectly placed knight, also attacking the bishop on b7. So Piquet played knight to a5, defending the bishop with the knight, and also attacking the bishop on b3. Bishop to c2. Well, Kasparov's plan is very simple. He wants to play queen to d3, and after moving the knight, checkmating the king on h7. So after bishop to c2, we have b3, attacking the bishop. Bishop to b1, defending. Queen to b6, and Kasparov played queen to d3, as planned. A very annoying move for black. He is threatening to move the knight, and then checkmating the king on h7. So g6, preparing to defend. In the future, knight to c5, moving the knight. Bishop to c8, defending the bishop, and h4 by Kasparov. Kasparov wants to play h5, attacking the pawn. Knight to c6, and a5, attacking the queen, sacrificing the pawn. And Jérôme Piquet captured the pawn. Queen takes on a5. Can you guess the next move of Kasparov? He played a very beautiful move. Well, what would you do in this position? And in this position, Garry Kasparov sacrificed his knight. He played knight takes on f7 by Kasparov, a knight sacrifice. Rook takes on f7. Well, what else? Kasparov was threatening checkmate. Queen takes on g6 after knight takes on f7. But then queen takes on g6. This is check. How to defend? Decisions for black. Black played king to f8. If rook to g7, then queen to e8. This is check. Also attacking the knight. And white is better after capturing the knight with the queen. After queen takes on g6, we have king to f8. And Garry Kasparov played knight takes on e6. This is check again. Bishop takes knight on e6. And rook takes on c6. But still, black is a piece up. And attacking the bishop, defending the bishop, bishop to d7. Kasparov is a piece down. But in this position, he played a killer move. And after that move, black resigned. Kasparov simply captured on h6 with the queen, and black resigned. What a game by Kasparov. Black had enough, because whatever he does, he is losing the game after this position. So let me show you the possible continuation. If blocking with the rook, if rook to g7, then rook to g6, and the rook is pinned. So let's say king to e8, and rook takes rook. White has the exchange. And also white has two extra pawns in this position. White is better. And if king to e8, then e6, forking the bishop and the rook. If daring to capture the rook with the bishop, then e takes on f7. This is check. King to d8, queen to h8, king to d7, and bishop to f5. Checkmate. And if king to g8, then black is not going to live for too long. Rook to g6, check. Blocking with the rook. Queen takes rook on g7, check, mate. What a fearsome attack by Kasparov. So this is why after queen takes on h6, black resigned. And I hope to see you next time. Take care and bye bye.